Good evening and welcome to BV Duansan News of the Week. My name is Emma Doe. In today's news, a noted Vietnamese-American aerospace scientist visits Melbourne. Four boat refugees put on trial in Vietnam. And the Vietnamese government grants amnesty to over 4,000 prisoners. To today's top story, a much-noted Vietnamese-American aerospace scientist and educator is visiting the Vietnamese community in Melbourne. Retired Professor Vinh Xuân Nguyen is a leader in the global Vietnamese community. Nguyen was formerly a pilot for the French Air Force in the 50s and held high rankings as the member of the South Vietnamese Air Force before he emigrated to the United States. He's also an author with a number of books under his belt and over 100 technical papers in mathematics, astrodynamics, and trajectory optimization. His novel titled Pilot's Life was awarded the Republic of Vietnam's National Presidential Literature Prize. Professor Vinh told TV Tuần San he believes in a brighter future for Vietnam.
I'm always Vietnamese and I want just to visit my friend. I want to visit the real Vietnamese, the Vietnamese who still think of a bright future for Vietnam. And especially I'm closer to the younger generation. I like to, even my own experience, just if I have a chance to talk to them, that even now, if you're Australian, you're American, you have friends, that citizenship, but you still come from Vietnam and you still want for the country to become famous and have a good regime for people to grow up.
Professor Vinh holds the 2007 Dirk Bauer Prize for Outstanding Lifetime Achievement in the field of space flight mechanics and astrodynamics. He'll be at Footscray's Rama restaurant tomorrow night from 8:30 to 10:30 p.m. in an event dedicated to his life and work. A number of people who fled Vietnam for Australia on a fishing boat in May this year are now facing trial for charges of human trafficking. Four passengers out of the 21 people on the fishing boat are now facing various jail sentences. Australia's Human Rights Watch and one woman on the boat claim that the Vietnamese government promised not to jail boat people leaving Vietnam in search of work. Despite this, one of the defendants is facing between 7 to 15 years in jail for what the government deems as organising for others to flee the country illegally. The fishing boat left Vietnam on May 18 this year before it reached Australian waters in June. The arrivals were returned to Vietnam by airplane and arrived at Dan Son Nhat Airport in Ho Chi Minh City on June 16. The four defendants will be tried later in December. It will be the third time this year that the Vietnamese government has charged citizens who were returned by Australia. 13 Vietnamese nationals are being detained in Cairns for illegally fishing in Australian waters for sea cucumbers. The Department of Immigration and Border Protection released a statement on Wednesday stating that more than 3 tonnes of sea cucumbers, considered a delicacy in Southeast Asia, were found on the vessel northeast of Rockhampton. The Vietnamese crew were seen dumping some of their catch overboard as Australian border agents approached the boat inside a conservation zone. The crew is detained in Cairns while the Australian Fisheries Management Authority considers whether to lay charges. Over to news in Vietnam. A high-profile Vietnamese farmer and activist has lost a bid to overturn her 20-month jail term for protesting against illegal land grabs. The decision has outraged human rights groups, including the New York-based Human Rights Watch, who called for the 54-year-old Gan Thi Theo to be released immediately. Due to Vietnam's boom in real estate, small landowners have been evicted to clear space for construction projects. Those protesting say the evictions are illegal and that they are being paid inadequate compensation from authorities. Theo's lawyer on Wednesday told media that the initial sentence had remained unchanged. It's not clear whether the activists will appeal the verdict in a higher court. Vietnam has granted amnesty to more than 4,000 prisoners, including one sentenced to 5 years in jail for a national security-related crime. Vietnam's deputy chairman of the president's office told a press conference that 4,384 inmates were granted amnesty under two directives signed by the president. The prisoners will be released starting today. They include 14 foreigners, among them one Australian. One pardoned Vietnamese prisoner has served 3 years of his sentence for organising people to flee to neighbouring Cambodia. International human rights groups have urged the Vietnamese government to pardon the hundreds of political prisoners it claims the government holds. It remains unclear whether any jailed dissidents are part of the group given amnesty, and Hanoi maintains that it holds no political prisoners. Local police seized 120 live cobras from a bus in Vietnam's central Dac Nong district on Wednesday night. According to the state-run Deutsche newspaper, the snakes were carried in 15 plastic boxes. The driver of the bus told police he was hired to transport cobras from the northern province of Vĩnh Phúc to Ho Chi Minh City. The snakes were confiscated by police for violating a ban on transporting products dangerous to people. Cobra is eaten as a delicacy in Vietnam and is used in traditional medicines. Vietnam has condemned Taiwan's military drills in the Spratly Islands, a part of which Vietnam is claiming sovereignty over. Vietnam's Ministry of Foreign Affairs says the drills in question are carried out on what Vietnam calls Ma Binh Island. Taiwan currently uses the disputed island, most recently conducting search and rescue exercises on Tuesday. In a statement, the Vietnamese ministry demanded Taiwan refrain from the military drills, labelling the country's actions as a serious violation of Vietnam's sovereignty, as well as a threat to peace, stability and security in the area. China, Taiwan, the Philippines, Vietnam, Malaysia and Brunei claim parts or all of the energy-rich East Sea in which the Spratly Islands are found. Trillions of dollars in annual trade pass through the sea. A new study has revealed that 15% of the Vietnamese population, or approximately 13.5 million people, suffer from common mental illnesses. The study conducted by the Ministry of Labour, Invalid and Social Affairs showed that some 200,000 Vietnamese people suffer from severe mental illnesses. Of those, 37% are yet to receive medication for treatment. The ministry said about 18% of families of people with severe mental illnesses reportedly face discrimination from the community. As such, the ministry is aiming to roll out awareness programs to combat discrimination. Vietnam has 45 social protection centres nationwide that offer care for mental disorders. The ministry cites a shortage of facilities and trained staff as a challenge and says it is working to provide services for 90% of people with severe mental illnesses by 2020. Vietnam will hold a national day of mourning for Cuban revolutionary leader Fidel Castro on December 4. Vietnamese institutions, as well as the country's agencies in foreign nations, are required to hang flags at half-mast and wear mourning bands on the day. According to an official statement, public entertainment activities will also be restricted. Both the Vietnamese President, National Assembly and various government committees have agreed on the National Day of Mourning to express their gratitude to the late Cuban leader. Vietnam and Cuba first established diplomatic ties in 1960. Fidel Castro visited Vietnam officially three times, first in 1973, over 20 years later in 1995, and most recently in 2003. Castro led Cuba for 49 years after the 1959 revolution. He passed away at the age of 90 late last week. That's all from TV Tuần San, News of the Week. I'm Emma Doe. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to your company at the same time next week.